Hello, everyone. Welcome to Brett and Sebastian's real gay wedding for genuine humans who aren't robot aliens. real genuine humans who are genuine human gay men and not robot aliens. Nope, not at all. So thank you guys so much for coming out and sharing this really incredible and special day with Brett and Sebastian. This is gonna be like a whole thing. So, of course it's a whole thing. And it's like really well organized. So just like keep that in mind like while it's happening, like wow, this is so well organized. Like that's like just gonna be going through your head like over and over and over again. So there's going to be basically a performance aspect of the ceremony, and then there will be an intermission where hopefully we'll swap some seats and get some drinks and go to the bathroom and swap some seats. And then there'll be kind of a second half that'll be a little bit more of a traditional ceremony, and then they're gonna get fucking married. Yeah. I just said the F word. I'm gonna avoid saying it for the rest of the night because there are small children looking at me. We like it. We're so excited that you're here. I love your pretty dress. Very cute. Just so you guys know, this is like, so, it's a sweater, I'm sorry, you're right. Let's get it over with. What's going to happen, just so you guys know, this is like a performance, so please laugh and clap. It's not like I feel like whenever I go to like wedding ceremonies, I'll be like, clap! Oh, you don't clap, there's no clapping. Like there's no like moments of like, yeah, we did it! Everyone's like, stop, there's no clapping, it's at the very end. It's like, oh no. So that's not what this is, this first part. You get to clap as much as you want. Thank you. Look at your pretty chubby cheeks. I love it. I'm going to stop talking to the child and talk to everybody. First up, we're going to do some improv and some character sketches and a really cool presentation that's a secret for you guys. Before we do that, but just for the improvisers who are performing, know that I'm going to read your names so that you know when to come up because I didn't tell anyone. So thank you everyone so much for coming out. Let's get started, all right? So first up, we're gonna be interviewing one of Sebastian's brothers. So I'll be interviewing them, and that will be kind of inspiring the improv set. So if Sean could come up. Thank you, Sean. And then for the improv, let's read some names. There we go. Can we have Kirk, Damato, Katey, Rosario, Meghan, Kaye, Angela, Damanti, Meredith, Hackman, Curtis, Retherford, Ethan, Kaye, Pat, Baer, and Meghan O'Keefe. Your winter coats, your outer coats, your outer layer, because we're humans and we know what it is. So before I interview Sean, just want to let everyone know, why was I saying that? I genuinely don't remember, so never mind, yay!
Hi, Sean.
Hello.
Hi. So you're
Sebastian's brother, correct?
Yes.
Great, and so there's four of you total,
yes.
Correct? What's the age order?
It's Stuart John, Stephen
okay.
James.
Okay.
Sean Joseph?
That's you.
That's me.
Yeah, that's you.
And then Sebastian.
Okay, great. Cool. That's a lot of Satan's.
Yes, yes.
Yeah.
There's a little bit of Catholic in us. I don't know if you noticed.
Have you really realized that?
I don't know.
We have like a really enthusiastic audience already. So yeah, I just wanted to ask you guys, what was Sebastian like growing up?
Like, what do you mean?
Was he a
creep?
Was he like a sneaky kid?
He was a sneaky creep. No, he was pretty popular.
Yeah.
I can tell you that I was 2 years ahead of him in school.
Okay.
And when we hit high school, I was known as Little Deken before he got there.
Mm-hmm.
And by the time I got there, I was Deacon's older brother.
Oh. sisters, and there are lots of things that happened that my parents didn't know about. You know what I mean? Like the time we set the dining room rug on fire.
Sure, yeah.
So what is one of those stories for you guys?
There's several stories that we...
The window.
So, it started, we were at my Aunt Debbie's house, and this is involved the parents, they knew what was going on.
Okay.
Sebastian wandered out the window, is what... Sebastian was a wee tot.
Okay.
And there was a trampoline outside.
Oh boy.
Okay, yep. And somehow he ended up outside.
All right.
Most of the brothers, I was not old enough to realize what was going on at the time, but most of the brothers said he wandered out the sliding glass door. Mm-hmm. But my Aunt Debbie and my mom insisted that someone had put him out the window. And here you go, out the window. But it was like a 4 or 5 hour ordeal of being interrogated.
They already found him?
We had been caught the previous night sneaking out.
When they saw him
outside, the only possible explanation is that someone had opened the window and put Sebastian outside. Not that he walked out in front of them through the sliding glass door. That could not have happened.
So how old is Sebastian at this point?
Five.
Yeah.
Okay, five. Okay, great. Love it.
Yeah.
So he wasn't missing.
Found him almost immediately.
Yeah, so this is just like an interrogation after the fact.
Right.
Yeah. We got to find out what happened.
There was bringing people into other rooms, and I know at one point they said, okay, we're going to have you guys write who put him out the window, and we're never going to know by your handwriting. And like Stuart got a crayon, and Stephen got a pen, and my cousin Greg got a pencil. And so it was pretty obvious that they knew what was going on.
Yeah. Okay, great. Do you have a favorite memory of kind of when all of you came together as brothers and like overcame something?
There's that. I mean, I don't know, coming together. I mean, there's plenty of stories about Sebastian getting put into things or being lost. Stephen put Sebastian in the piano once.
Right, the one that was in the basement?
Yes.
I've heard about this piano. We're friends.
I think at that point Sebastian was probably very inquisitive and playing while Stephen was practicing and was put in the piano and closed.
He closed the
piano and just went right upstairs.
We were collaborating.
Why did he go in?
Yeah, and then he turned off.
we like monkeys helping the person perform, where you're just like, I'm playing the piano too.
And smoking a cigar.
Right. Well, thank you so much. And give it up for sure.
Hey, Mom, are you watching the concert? Mom, do I have you? Are you on the phone? Are you watching the concert? Is she watching the concert?
Yeah, I'm watching the concert.
Hey, we're in the piano.
Okay.
We're in the piano. There's like hammers, they're hitting us.
Okay, find the F sharp.
They all look F sharp.
Okay, well, the one that sounds like an F sharp, David? That was an F sharp! I'm one octave up! Go one octave, other way! I have a camera installed, but it's all reversed.
Mom, you installed a camera in the piano, but
yes.
We're still stuck in here. Can we stop the concert?
No, the concert must continue.
There are 1,200 people out there, and they don't care about the F sharp.
Oh, the F sharp is the key of this concerto. Brahms did not die in vain.
Was he murdered?
Yes, he died of shame when two of his distant relatives messed up the F sharp. Look, we have a monkey playing this piano. He's smoking. We need someone to give the archivist that this is a correct Brahms concerto.
I'm gonna give it a second try.
But you fool!
It's so funny! They're doing a monkey! A monkey is playing!
They're unimpressed! No, don't peek up! But whatever you do, they must believe that this monkey is really playing. I'm really tipping his hat!
He started his second cigar. Does that mean it's almost over?
This is a five-cigar concerto, David!
There are no problems when you have it! Okay.
Alright, well, you know what?
I've got my ringtone! My ringtone is a Brahms concerto! Call me back! Come on!
Call
log?
No, contact.
Alright. Oh, the service in that piano is terrible.
Baby outside the window.
I wasn't the only one involved.
Oh, we know your sneaky, sneaky brother already turned on you.
This is literally how it came.
Crayons and pens. I want to write some stuff down. It's all crayons and pens.
Oh, good.
That's what this police force needs.
Someday this is gonna make a great story at a fucking wedding. I mean, but right now, you get in there, pick a crayon or a pencil. Only one kind of drawing utensil.
Okay.
Now draw a picture of a baby falling out a window.
How is this going to prove anything?
You don't understand how the police force works.
I'm not the only one.
Are you going to admit who the other people were?
Oh, you mean if I just pass the buck on to someone else, you'll let me go?
Yes.
All right, we've got a drawing of her accomplices, so we can find them in this lineup. Okay, let's see. One of them is like a round circle with like a line, and then. We got a happy cloud. I think that's just incidental to this. Okay, well, you're frowning. That's pretty close. We got two puppy dogs.
You got a son with sunglasses in that lineup?
Yeah, I got a son.
And don't forget the kangaroo with the boxing glove.
You were set free, kangaroo, okay? Go find a life outside of this, okay?
I'm not in the drawing?
No, you're not.
Okay.
No, I'm risking.
What?
On the best trampoline in the tri-state area.
I mean, yeah.
Costs a lot of money, or
It costs nothing.
What?
It costs your pride.
What? Give that. Give up.
If you can give me your pride.
Sure. Can I add a kidney to it, maybe, or?
You're giving me more than I'm asking for.
Wait. I'm sorry. Are you the devil asking for like the bare minimum for? Souls?
Souls are cheap! Anyone can sell a soul. But pride, that's where the real American money is.
Okay, if it's the best ride in the state.
It's a trampoline, you've been on it before! See how easy that was? He's enjoying the trampoline!
Would this bubble of luxury photos count for that?
That is all of your pride!
ability to jump, so I don't know. I have nothing.
What are you giving me, dog? This is embarrassing.
All I have is envy and a small amount of jealousy. Like a little bit.
Jealousy against who, may I ask?
I mean, people that can jump as they're smiling. I don't know what to do. I don't know.
It's quite easy. What's that?
Excuse me, the devil?
Yes, it's me.
Hell is really waiting for you. Are you almost done with the trip?
This is great.
Okay, all right.
I'm having a blast.
I know it's really going to crap, but you just have fun, okay?
No, I will not sacrifice my guilt for the trampoline. Ooh. The devil's gone from hell! Let's do good things!
Oh, let's make rainbows! Let's give puppies voices!
What's he doing?
What?
Something is off. Something is off. Wait! How did that happen?
Somebody put me here.
What?
I didn't come out here on my own.
Somebody yes, she did.
Put me here. I was placed.
Well, first, let's get you out of the dummy elevator. I don't even know how you would get in there. All right. Something elaborate must have happened. And it must have involved everyone else in this house.
I'm all in on it. Mm. I was just sitting there, reading.
Several cookies are missing! How could that be? You love cookies.
But I would never take them.
No, you wouldn't. You wouldn't take cookies. If I left the kitchen, you wouldn't eat cookies.
Because you told me not to eat cookies.
This house is full of lies. Lies and conspiracies. And not enough cookies.
You do need more cookies.
I mean, yes. Well, certainly. All right, family meeting. Family meeting. Okay. Stephen James, and Sean Jacob, and Stephanie Jessica, and Susan Jessica, and Shirley,
Jessica.
That's right, cousin Jessica is here.
Four female saints? Whoops. Did you run out of names after four female saints?
Well, Saint Jessica is the greatest of them.
And I remember the thing that I forgot earlier, which was don't forget Brett and Sebastian's wedding hashtag, which is hashtag BrettAndSeb4E. So forever. The letter E, not the drug. Alright, so thank you guys so much. The next thing we have coming up, so I just want to welcome to the stage Carla. So Carla.
Working it down.
And apparently the story is that that was one of the first shows.
The first show
that you saw. And Brett was freaking out, and he's like, I hope he thinks it's funny, I don't know. And then the sketch that we're going to do for you is essentially the one we did, I think it was in 2010, the first sketch that you saw.
That Brett wrote, right?
What's
that?
That
Brett wrote.
Yeah.
That Brett wrote. Yeah, yeah, yeah. And you actually knew that Brett wrote it.
Yeah, yeah.
Correct. So we'll see if you guys feel the same. and hopefully you put your way in. Keep it silent tonight. Also, we made a few slight tweaks to it, just because it was written in 2010. just real slight ones, but you'll see. About love, but you gotta be smart about it.
Yes, so one time I almost got married to this man, James Herpes. All right, come to find out his last name was spelled H-E-R-P-E-S. James, are you fooling? That's herpes. Carla, herpes? Uh-uh, not since 1993. Real hard. Okay. But you need a man, I don't know, you marrying someone who does comic books for a living.
So that was, yeah, right.
Oh, I did, yeah. Yeah,
so, congratulations. That was Leslie Ellismayo. I said the whole thing because I'm Hackman too. So yeah, thanks so much. And for Zhubin, aka Mayor DeBomzio. Right? That's your new name.
It was Mayor Boomberg.
Oh. Time changes. Time moves on. It's never the same. So cool. Second up, we have another improv team. This improv team name is KOOPA Troopas. Reference to something that Sebastian likes. So we will be interviewing one of Brett's friends from Tennessee, Nicole Tekulve. I'm sorry, I wrote it out. But yeah, give it up for Nicole, everybody. Charlie Todd, Cody Lindquist. Dan Chamberlain, Moujan, Zolfaghari, Zhubin, who's already here, Julia Whitehouse, Matt Shafeek, Sam Gerwitz, and Kirk Enther. Yeah, hey, here we go. Yeah, we got a Kirk, we got a Dan. Oh, yeah. We got a Julia. Oh, yeah. Put it down the back. And can we have a Moujan? Here. So, oh, there you are. I saw you.
Elevate
your
best.
Okay, here we go.
Hi, Nicole. Hi. Let's head out to the center, okay? Yeah, in the thick of it. So thank you so much for coming up to be interviewed about Brett and his wild and misspent youth. When did you meet Brett first?
Oh, God. I actually remember the first time I met Brett.
Ooh.
Yes, it was at Carrie Rollison's 15th birthday party.
Yeah.
And typical Brett, he was holding court and annoying the shit out of everyone.
I have no idea what you're talking about.
No. It was Carrie's party, but it was Brett's party. Yes.
Okay, so this is, you guys went to the same high school, but it's like the first, and the same college as well. But this is like, that's the first time you're meeting, right? So like, do you have a memory of like what he was holding court about? Was it music?
I mean, we were like watching a TV show.
Oh, okay.
And I think Brett had opinions.
No! No way!
I had opinions on a TV show?
I know, it's crazy.
My honestly.
So great. So what's a memory that you have of Brett getting into trouble, but then just like getting out of trouble, or maybe just ending staying in trouble if you could manage to get out of it?
Oh God. There's a few. There's
we're getting that information from
there. Yeah, I got help down here. So, junior year for you?
Yeah.
Junior year, we were both in marching band.
Yeah.
Brett was a junior, I was a senior, and we played a game on Halloween. So everyone in the band dressed up because we're geeks. So
yeah.
We're doing that. And Brett dressed up as Nightcrawler.
Yes, man.
Full on paint everywhere. And it was a great game. We all had fun. And then as we're leaving, Brett has never been the best driver, I would say. And so we're leaving the game, and Brett pulls out of the parking lot and immediately gets hit by someone,
yeah.
I think.
Total that car.
Yeah. Yeah. So, and the police, you know, come to the scene, and Brett's in full on
night. My friend Adam McCord was in the passenger seat dressed like a corpse. And also, Bush's glycerin, I think, was playing.
Yes!
Excellent song.
He's a bad person.
Gavin Rossdale?
Yeah, he cheated on his beautiful wife. So, let's get back to Brett. It's always about Brett. Well, yes, it is. You guys went to college together. Did you major in television production as well? Or?
No.
Okay, cool. That's a great face. Like, I did not.
Sorry.
What did you major in?
History.
Great. What you guys did kind of has the same amount of staying power.
Yeah, you.
Not the best. So great. So did you guys live on campus at all? Were there any campus items?
No.
So everyone just kind of came in. You guys did school stuff. Then you're like, let's do band, and I'm out of here.
Yeah.
Pretty much.
Cool.
Yeah.
So what is do you have a memory of a time that Brett kind of reached out to someone when you were like not expecting him to
Yes, he reached
out. I wasn't trying to lead to that.
Yeah. I felt like you were going somewhere. we all were drinking and having a good old college time at our local college bar.
The Borough.
The Borough Bar and Grill. And Brett, you know, calls us. He's like, hey, what are you guys doing? Can I come over? And we're like, sure, come on over. And Brett comes over and he's like super frenetic, kind of. Like, he's a little manic. You know, and he basically comes out to us by a dumpster.
One by one.
He's like,
individually, too.
Yeah.
He took us one by one. And we were all like, basically like, yeah, woo, go Brett! Because it had been a long time coming, so.
Because we were drunk, and then you guys like, it's a long time coming. So, you know, those two things.
Yeah.
But yeah, thank you so much.
Party. I know we've all been talking and whatever, but my mom got a DVD of X-Files from Blockbuster. I'm going to watch it right now, and I just want y'all to be quiet because it's my favorite. I told the DJ to go home and get out of here.
It's my birthday, though.
I know, but if these DVDs just came out, they're real hard to get, and my mom works at Blockbuster, so I was able to get them.
You're right.
Can we watch the Ghost Ship episode?
Oh, I'd love that episode.
Yeah.
Oh, really, you know that it's not just episodic, it's also serialized.
Yo, would anyone like some brownies on my brownies?
They're
peanuts in them.
I'm allergic to peanuts.
I know.
They're
his favorite.
We can chit chat while the FBI warning is still on the TV, but let's wrap this up.
Dan, it's me, your father. I haven't been here for you in 20 years, but I realized that, oh, is this the X-Files?
Yeah, it's the first episode. It's on DVD now, just released.
Oh, all right, well, let's watch this. This is awesome. Yeah. You seem like a pretty cool kid. I gotta tell you this right now.
Thanks a lot. A lot of people say I have some unconventional ideas and theories. I'm looking for somebody who can maybe keep me in check.
I have brought you all here to give you some news. Please just wait. I want to tell you, Mom's not doing well. No. Move it one at a time.
No one else listen right now. I haven't been a great dad to all of you, okay? I'm trying to do some one-on-one time. Unfortunately, you all arrived at the same time. I'm not going to let that change my plans. How's Mom? How is Mom doing?
She's not doing well.
Oh, God.
We might have minutes.
Okay, my turn, my turn.
Wait, wait, wait.
Susie.
I'm ready. What do you... One-on-one
time. One-on-one time.
Okay.
I have some shocking news for you. Mom is not doing well.
We already heard that. Get to the next one.
You shouldn't have heard that.
It's right here.
Dad, it kind of smells out here. Can we do it somewhere else?
No. No.
I can't believe you brought it to the dumpster next to the Japanese steakhouse.
It didn't have seating enough for all of us. We could meet here.
Where is she?
She's at the hospital across the way.
Let's go to the hospital.
We are going so out of order right now. Wait your damn turn.
This is all better than this. As I was saying, it's not going to be long now. Oh, yes.
Yeah.
Hey, what's going on? How was your game earlier today? Good?
It's a real good game, Dad.
You don't look like you had a good game.
Well, I've been kind of worried about Mom.
I didn't say anything, but I will say, I didn't get any of this chit-chat beforehand.
You didn't have a game earlier. Coach put you in, I talked to him earlier.
Thanks for talking to him for me.
Yeah.
I really wanted to go in this game, and I did.
Well, I've got some news. You noticed that Mom and I weren't there today at your game.
I know this.
Mom's not doing well.
We all were there. We all were there. She got hit by a bus. Move on.
Should I send the next kid?
I know. He should be doing better in soccer. Oh my God. Okay, Mom got hit by the bus. A lot of internal bleeding. Something I probably should bring up. I should have asked at the beginning. What are your blood types? Disaffected modern day teen shit, huh? What about you guys back there? What about that?
What are you dressed as?
They're not alive.
What?
Well, we thought it would add to the outfit if we got some real corpses. And I'm saying this out loud now, and it's a bad idea.
Those are two dead bodies in the back of your car?
Yeah. And my little brother, the other James.
So how
were these the two bodies that were taken from the funeral homes this morning before the funeral got a chance to begin?
So how fast were we going? I'm sorry.
It's not even about that if you want to get more. But to be honest with you, you were going a mile above the speed limit and I had a quota I had to fill. Have some apologies to make to some very upset families. You can't just cancel a funeral just because the body is gone. Do you realize that? There has to be a funeral. The caterer's been scheduled.
Thank you for bringing the bodies back.
Yeah, we just drove the car in.
That's what I wasn't thrilled with. You changed costumes now. Are you McDonald Land characters?
Yes, we are.
I am the Hamburglar.
Okay.
Yeah. And I am a small child who goes to McDonald's.
Do not arrange and pose them.
No. That's what we were doing in the car, but it's not appropriate for the funeral.
This is a lot. This is a lot for me to take in right now. Okay, we got an open casket, and the casket was empty. What possessed you to take these bodies?
Just fun.
Just fun.
And then if you can notice now, they're in a better mood.
Yeah. Have you seen the movie Weekend at Bernie's?
Please do not weekend at Bernie's, my dead man.
We'll just leave him here. Do you want the hats off?
I understand that your relatives have now been found, but we already buried the open casket.
You are not double charging me.
If you had bought the double wide plot like I pitched to you, I'd say you wouldn't have this problem anymore, now would you?
What a fucking racket.
How dare you? This is an honorable system. This is an honorable service, what I can do. And I don't.
Do you know what I've been through? Okay? Two rowdy college age kids took two corpses from a casket, went on a ride with them, got arrested. Drove back with them into the funeral home.
That's my funeral home,
yes.
I know!
Okay? Attempted to pitch a Weekend at Bernie's style event after all they did. And now I'm here with you renegotiating, reburying the casket.
Here's what I can do. And I'm not supposed to even tell you this. it's frankly against the law. But if you can. If before the next burial, you sneak. Your beloved one.
Are you saying I need to rehire those rowdy kids for another escapade?
He's tall.
I want to be clear. I'm not thrilled about this.
So much KOOPA TROOPAS, thank you so much. Wow, I feel like I have a real like insight into your college life. It's like exactly what happened, right? And I was like, oh boy, that was great. So thanks so much, KOOPA TROOPAS. So next up we have something, it's a little bit of a surprise. So I'm just gonna introduce Dan Samiljan. So Dan Samiljan, you wanna come up? So you can actually hold off on the music for now, because that'll give it away. So here we go. Yeah, thanks so much.
Hi, everyone. Thanks for clapping when you don't know who I am. I really appreciate it. Okay, I just want to say welcome to Match Game 17, the Human Game Wedding Edition. So he's changed the name to Golden Blank. A little music would feel very nice there.
I'm a comic book journalist, which is an actual profession.
Has everyone written a thing here? Okay, let's repeat it one more time. Did you hear that Brett is writing a reboot? Chris Davis,
yeah.
of an old favorite sitcom, but instead of the usual characters, he's written himself in Seb. So he's changed the name to Golden.
Oh, don't I get my answer?
Sorry, this is the first one.
No, sorry, I have 20 VHS tapes filled with Match Game. Golden Gaze.
Golden Gaze. Oh. We are looking for kids.
Well, you said specifically Brett, so like based on his recent Facebook post, I just wrote Golden Bobby Lark.
April.
All right, I got Golden Squirrels because there's some real friends.
My information came straight from the top, and I went with Golden Showers.
Chrissy.
I went a little over and above here, and I did Golden Showers with the American President.
Showers.
I think we're a match, Brett.
Jennifer, what do you got?
Jace.
Yay! Yay! All right, Seb, you're up.
Okay.
Well, they've heard Sebastian's demands, and the Metropolitan Opera is finally working on a Pokemon-themed opera. Finally. It's called The Marriage of Blank. So, they've heard Sebastian's demands, Metropolitan Opera is finally working on a Pokemon-themed opera. It's called The Marriage of Blank.
I work for Planned Parenthood.
Keep abortion safe and legal!
I wrote a bunch of articles about
answers here?
I got something.
All right. What's your answer, honey?
Do I go first?
Yeah. Session. They've heard your commands, and they're writing a new opera, Pokemon-themed opera. It is called The Marriage of...
Well, there are nearly 900 Pokemon. but because I want the matches, Alex, Dan, I'm going to go with Pikachu.
Damn. Marriage of Pikachu.
Oh, nice.
Well, I know that Seb loves his nap, so I chose Snorlax.
Oh!
I went with Pikachu's your true love.
Because Brett is so cuddly, I went with Jigglypuff.
Chrissy, how are we looking?
Squirtle.
This is great.
I also had Squirtle.
Wow. All right, round two. Brett, you're going first. Question A or B?
Well, I'm just gonna keep going with B.
Right. As you may know, Sebastian has a new job at Planned Parenthood. In fact, he loves it so much. He loves it so much that tonight, everyone here is going home with blank. Tonight, everyone here is going home with what?
Yikes. Oh, no.
How's it going? This is a public Facebook video. Ask me again in a week.
All right. How are we looking here? Team, we're good? Panelists ready? All right. So, Brett, as you may know, Sebastian's new job playing Parenthood. Everyone here is going home with
a hug. Long-acting reversible contraceptive.
Reversible.
Yeah.
Themselves World Lottery ticket.
April, what you got?
We're clearly from the South. Diapers, adult, and infant.
Tonight, everyone goes home with three condoms and a baby!
Confused with the next 94 Damon Wayans movie playing. What I want to ask, is it like, Brett swims okay, or is it like, Brett swims okay?
I mean, it's both.
How many followers do you have to on that?
I mean, it's like 112.
Pull your phones and do it right now. At Brett swims okay.
See how many? How much I'm not swimming?
How many speeders do you own?
30 something.
Oh! Yeah.
I don't even own that many slots.
The new superhero.
You're doing a great job.
Discussion. Marvel Comics is working on a brand new superhero based on the Instagram comic. It will be known as
Speedo Man.
Yeah.
I got a sword in Speedo Man.
April.
Got them Speedos for your
Speedos. I went with Sweet Sweet Gams.
The always sexy Speedo Man.
Speedo.
Incredible shrinking.
Panel for playing. We have one last supermatch round we're going to do. You guys are going to do the supermatch. So we each get a piece of paper and a marker. Markers. Yep. And for the supermatch, please write down, without looking, your answers to this. Blank wedding. Channel of music. Blank wedding. You ready? Alright, on the count of three. Let's see it. One, two, three.
Yeah.
For this. So if anyone needs to like go to the bathroom or like see if they get a snack, maybe now is a good time to do that if you want. It's fine. You don't have to. You can stay and that's fine.
She's hungry.
Okay.
She won't last any longer.
Okay. I think there's food out in the restaurant area.
There's diaper bags back there.
Well, also that, but there's food. So don't eat diapers if you don't want to. That's what I'm saying. Only on Thursdays. Okay, cool. Now we're gonna have our last improv up, improv team up. This team is called Dessert Crawl. Because that's the thing you guys both like. It was very hard to find one. You guys have very distinct likes, and they don't overlap all that much. Please welcome to the stage John Robert Wilson, Chris Scott, the New York version, Jeremy Bent, Jess Wyant, Adam Bozark, Matt Little, Ben Rakeev, Ben Whitehouse, Melanie Hamlet, Rob Stern, and Lauren Gunther! Everyone has been known better for like 10 years. So. Yeah, oh cool, yeah! Cool.
So I just want to ask you guys, like, I know I've known you both for a long time, but what are some stories, what's a story about when you guys first knew each other that maybe I wouldn't know?
I do the stupider things, so you have the better story.
When we first started dating, So we went on our first date to a mac and cheese restaurant. And then it was smack. And afterward, we went walking around, and we ended up at this little coffee shop where I ate a piece of cheesecake, and Brett talked to me about music. Well, I asked for recommendations. Okay. It wasn't like the usual thing. But while we were walking between Smack and the coffee shop, we ran into Jeffrey Marks, who I think many improvisers might know.
Yeah.
Jeffrey is twice my size and twice as gay. And I remember he was very enthusiastic to see, because we just ran into each other. He was very enthusiastic about seeing Brett, gave Brett a big hug, and then he shook my hand and said, "We've never slept together." Which was true. So that's something you guys might not
know. Yeah. I love that you haven't slept with him just because he was our improv coach for a while.
Yeah.
That would be weird. Not as weird. You can sleep with your improv coaches if you're both old enough. It's fine. And I can take maps together, obviously. Okay, cool. So what is, when you guys get into like a little bit of a tiff, what's your go-to method for resolving that?
We have different arguing styles where Seb likes to let his emotions like calm down and like sit for a while, usually alone, to like think through his thoughts. And I am like, I'm sorry. What's wrong? No, we have to talk about it. I'm just gonna tell you how I feel right now.
I just need some space, guys.
For a while, I just needed to know that you weren't gonna like dump me right now because of the thing I did. I had a lot of bad boyfriends before I met this one.
And you still have one, but not for much longer.
Bad husband. So great. So if you guys could like, this is like gonna be like a little bit of a scene. If there was like a cartoon character or animal that you, the other person was that thing, what would that be and why?
Brett would be a dog.
Yeah, that makes
sense. Like a Boston Terrier.
I think he's gonna be mad that it's a Yankee dog.
Why a Boston Terrier? Because they're small and they got a lot of energy and feelings.
Basically,
family
that I
either
warm up,
I
either heat up rice and chicken, and then the Boston Terrier would eat it and immediately throw it up.
Yeah. That's great! Boston Terriers also love the X-Men.
Yeah. They look a lot like Nightcrawler, actually.
Yep.
They're a little flat face,
yep,
and they're Germans.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. I'd say Boston Terriers.
Boston Terriers, they're Russian.
No,
German, damn it. Okay, so,
that's a cat. Obviously.
Oh, the truth about cats and dogs.
What kind of cat?
I see, like, from my point of view, they're all just cats. I mean, you wouldn't be a long-haired cat.
Okay.
Because you don't have long hair.
I don't.
Okay, it's not looks. And he would have black fur.
Okay.
It's another inside joke we have, is I keep calling his hair black.
Yeah.
And it drives him
nuts. Yeah. Your hair is brown still.
Yes, my hair is still brown.
Also believes his hair is still brown.
I won't say, when we took an improv class together, and he dyed his hair, and he was like, nobody can tell, right? We could tell. So what's a specific cat? Maybe it's a cartoon cat? We need a little bit more information.
I mean, for a while, at your old job, you were definitely Garfield, because you hated Monday.
I love lasagna.
Yeah.
Not anymore. Atkins, guys. Atkins.
So, little bit more of a sad thing, but what's a one wish do you guys have for your future? Just one.
No genocide.
Like the genesis of OASIS. But the thing about that album is it was mastered perfect. You know, you the first three times that they recorded it, they had someone master it. Right? So think about what it was like to be in the theater listening to that. You get the song Super Sonic and it kicks in. Good.
That's why we're here.
Yeah.
Yes.
Okay. Everyone can have a seat, I guess.
Yeah, I think there's nothing.
Yeah, we only got four cops.
So I didn't fuck him, and I didn't fuck Brett, but I want to fuck Brett, and I send dick pics all the time. That's totally
fine. That's between you and Brett. I don't appreciate it, but that's kind of a situation between the two.
Will you guys send me pics of you
fucking? Hold on, everybody. Look, I don't know you guys.
It's John Voight.
And I'm actor John Voight.
We just said you were.
My friend bought your station wagon years ago.
You're confusing that with a plot of a Seinfeld. Right, I'm sorry.
Look, me and Brett dated for a while, and I just wanted you to know that it's completely over. We're fine.
Okay.
He talks to Angelina, I don't.
You should reach out.
Just say hi. Just ask her all the kids.
This is going off the rails. Oh, look,
your daughter needs you, Joe.
The cards on the table. John Voight. Fucked your boyfriend, Brett White. But it's all over.
Oh, I'm sorry, I was in the bathroom so long.
Yeah.
Anyway, standing on the shoulders of giants was not their best style.
I don't know, I think sometimes genocide is necessary. I know it's controversial.
No, husband's not going to get on board with that.
Well, I'm sorry. I'm the one audience member that won't clap for no genocide.
How could you? Genocide means a bunch of people die.
Oh, my God. No.
You didn't know what genocide was?
What did you think it was? What was in your
mind? I thought
everything is cheese.
I'm the most adorable Boston Terrier. The adoption farm.
I'm the cat.
Oh, I like the fact that you kind of have long hair, but don't really.
I'm just your average cat.
You know, I like that. I like someone who understands who they are and is okay with it. You're comfortable in your own fur.
You might think so.
I'm looking to adopt an animal.
Okay.
I want something with lots of feelings. But I want those feelings to be ambivalent.
I couldn't care what this conversation is.
Can I ask you a personal question?
Yeah.
Do you ever think like animals have their own like, secret language among them that they we just can't hear? Oh no, he's on.
Come back! No! I wanna make a sale! No!
Oh, it seems like John Arbuckle has pulled him back.
He'll towel this up like he always does. Thanks for responding to the ad.
Yeah, I saw it you wrote in your cartoon.
Yeah.
I'm a veterinarian and a woman whose name I can't remember.
Liz.
Thank you.
Well, I think you should have a cat. I mean, yeah, my cat is very ambivalent and he does not respect me in the least. And I really think that's what you're going for.
How does he feel about, like, weekdays in general?
There's one particular weekday he's not fond of. There's one in particular.
I love Mondays.
Oh, no.
Ow!
Brett?
Can we just stretch and share as we do this?
Sure.
What are we doing?
I hate this exercise.
I know. Brett?
Yeah? Sure.
We don't buy it. We don't buy it.
What are you guys talking about?
We don't buy it.
Brett, your hair is orange.
It's orange.
It's always been orange.
It's like Dragon Ball Z orange.
It was like very distinguished.
If it had always been orange, we wouldn't say anything. Jess has always orange hair.
Okay, guys, we're going to do another warm-up called Park Bench of Truth. Brett, why don't you sit down? Everybody else, just sit down really quick. Tell you what the thing is, okay? I'm going to look at my phone out in the hallway.
$20 an hour for this.
Guys, by the way, rates went up to $45 an hour.
Everybody Venmo me.
What's Venmo? Never mind. What a beautiful day it is.
Yeah, it's snowing. I don't like the snow.
We see there's a funny lamppost right here.
I'm sorry.
I'm just trying to start real here.
Okay.
I don't like the snow.
Okay, guys, before we start this opera practice, I just want to
stretch the chair as we do this.
Sebastian, your hair is black.
I know.
So people can go use the restroom and grab something to eat and get a drink. And if you have been sitting, maybe when you come back, don't sit. So some of the people who have been standing for a long time can sit. You don't have to, but I'm just encouraging it strongly. So thanks everybody. We'll be coming back in like 7-8 minutes, maybe a little bit more, for the ceremony half of this ceremony. So, thanks everybody. Yeah, woo! Yeah, we're gonna get started again. So thanks everyone, I hope you had a good break. I hope you went to the bathroom if you needed to do that. I hope you got some food if you needed some food. I just hope you're like taking care of yourselves, you know what I mean? Like, hashtag self-care. Yeah, so self-care is like really important. And it's not just about like getting donuts because you're sad. It's about like making responsible choices for your life to be better. You get it? Like, maybe it's about, like, getting married right away. Because we don't know what the future holds.
7 years later, right away.
Yeah, seven, like, get engaged and then just, like, be like, oh, boy, money's bad. And then, oh, God, we gotta do this right now. Because,
good stuff.
Yeah, the world's gonna so cool. So this is the ceremony part of the ceremony show. So first up, we're going to have a story told by one of Brett. Brett and I met first at an improv class in October of 2006. We are old. And the next person who's going to be coming on stage, we met in that class, right? No. In 201. In February 2007. Thank you. I've been friends with Brett for 10 years, guys. He has a spreadsheet of every improv suggestion he's ever gotten, and I'm not kidding. A spreadsheet. So this person we met in that 201, and we were on our first indie improv team together called Bad Data. Thanks, guys. We're pretty good.
They saw our show.
Yeah, you guys came to that one show at the Keisha.
Yeah!
Rest in peace. Okay, so this person is really amazing, but just fair warning, it is going to be an adult piece. More so than the rest. So some of the children have gone on a little walk. So once this is done, if anyone near the back door could just go grab them in the restaurant area afterwards, that would be great, because I don't want to miss the rest of it. Cool. Yeah, so please welcome to the stage, Melanie Hamlet. I didn't know I was going to be in the ceremony part. That's an honor. They were, I got an email from Katey saying, Sebastian wants you to tell your clown fucking story at the wedding, and I was like...
For context, my mother was a professional clown.
I did not know that, and I was like, what? All the stories, the clown fucking story. I really hope you aren't mad that I went against your wishes, because they also didn't tell me there was going to be kids, and I was like, oh my god, that's the dirtiest story I have. This is pretty dirty too. But this one is more relevant, I think, so, and maybe you haven't heard it, so maybe, clown fuck, we don't need to talk about clowns, but getting fucked by clowns. Anyway, that's another show. I'm sorry. So I'm going to tell a different story. Same continent though, same trip. In 2014 or 12, I booked a one-way ticket to South America because it seemed like a good idea, and I wandered around for a while. I ended up in Bariloche in Argentina after, you know, kind of trying to see where I wanted to be. And it'd been a few weeks, so I wanted some friends finally, because wandering around is lonely. And I was doing couch surfing. Does anyone know what that is? Yeah, of course you do. If you don't, it's not as shady as it sounds, but you sleep on the couches of total strangers. and for some reason, only men would host me. I don't know why. Anyway, so my first host in Bariloche, his name was Tuda. And he looked a lot like Phil from Modern Family, like sharp, you know, features, and he was obsessed with Messi and, you know, soccer or football, and he could break a banana in half with his hands, which I do that now all the time. It's amazing. Anyway, he was really funny, and so we became friends, and like, he's my only friend in Argentina, and, you know, we kind of started playing a little bit, and one day we're sitting on his couch, and like, he like puts his hand on it, and I hadn't fucked anyone in like a year, so I was like, so he went and like took a shower, and while I was in the shower, I was like so riled up just from a human being touching me. When you're single, no one fucking touches you. You have to get massages to get, and not like the dirty ones either, just like massages to get someone touching. Anyway, that's not the So I was like, ugh. So while I was in the shower, I was like. I was so riled up, and I was afraid to fuck my couch surfing host because that would make shit weird. So I had seen something about Mary, and I was like, well, I know for guys, if they just like jack off before a date, then they don't actually like want to fuck that person as bad. So masturbated while he was in the shower. Aren't you glad those kids are not in here right now? I'm so nervous. I thought Katey was like, gotta get the kids out of here. Anyway. So I masturbated while I was in the shower, and apparently it's different for guys and girls. Guys, they just go their own, they're like, I'm going to sleep, or let's move on with our day. So girls are like, yeah! So like, he comes out of the shower, and I'm like, I'm fucking this dude. And I did! It really is bed surfing. They should call the site bed surfing because you do fuck people you stay with a lot of times, right? This one does. Anyway, so now me and Tuda are like kind of in a weird dating-ish relationship, kind of, because I'm like there for a while. I mean, I'm not going to stay with them all the time, but anyway, I'm fucking someone that I'm actually kind of been hanging out with that I like. Which is new for me. I usually only fuck guys I don't like. Or like, you know, one night stands, hate folks, this kind of thing. This would have been most of my life. And I'm still single. hear about hate folks at a wedding. Anyway, so we're hanging out and we did what like couples do. Again, I'd never really been in like a relationship before. I was like, oh, you eat dinner with someone you fuck. Wow, you go to the beach with someone you fuck. This is kind of cool. And then one day, like after like a week, I ended up staying like across the street at another couch surfer's place because I was like, this is weird. I'm in like a committed relationship with someone that I literally just met. So that guy didn't try to fuck me. Anyway, So one day, Tudor and I like texted him like, "Hey, you wanna go to the lake?" He didn't respond, so I sent an email. And in the email, I was like, you know, "Hey, you know, just so you know, like, I'm really enjoying this. Like, I kind of like you." And I never do that shit, you know, because I'm an empowered feminist who never has moved. Anyway, I really fucked up ideas of feminism like that. Anyway, so I like put my heart out there, and I didn't hear back from him. And I still didn't hear back from him. So I was like, "Fuck this guy, I don't need a man, I'm going to the bar," you know? It took like 2 hours and I hadn't heard from him. Fuck open! I'm going to the bar to get laid. So I go to the bar and go dance to techno. By the way, I don't drink at all. All the things you hear in this story are totally sober, which makes me look really bad. So I go to the club, I dance to techno because that's like my thing, I love it. And Argentinians, they stay out till like 10 in the morning. They never sleep. So at like 4 or 5 in the morning, I don't know when, some guy comes through the door and he's got like pirate smile and flipped up collar and he's like, "Gorgeous Argentinian man," and we just like lock eyes and I'm like, "That one." Very dance! And then like, he also doesn't speak any English. And my Spanish is like, you know, it's not that great. So we're not here to talk anyway. So I follow him out to his car and we go somewhere. This is why all my friends and family think I'm gonna get murdered all the time. They're like, no one even knows me here. What city I'm in, and I know what country I'm in. I'm just like, I'm gonna get in a car with a strange man. So we end up at a lake. And I'm thinking, this is before I fuck so many dudes on Tinder. Not thinking, well, how romantic, we're gonna hang out and watch the sunrise and then we'll go fuck. No. He like immediately gets on top of me, like throws on a condom and we're like fucking, and it's like the worst sex ever, because it's like no warming up, no, you gotta eat me out when we get off. Anyway. Pretty single piece on my head, like, so he'd be like, it's like, and maybe 60 seconds, I don't even know. And then we're like done. And then he just like wraps ties the condom up, throws it out the window like a fucking grenade, lights a cigarette, and we just take off. And I'm like, oh, okay. I think maybe we're going back to his place, you know, because in my mind, a one night stand, you get the whole night and multiple fucks, you know. No, we go back to the bar. It's like a 1 hour stand, not even. 1 minute. I just realized this today. He may have said in Spanish, like, "All right, bitch, get the fuck out," but I wouldn't have known because I can't understand what he's saying. So I'm just like still hanging out with this guy. We go back to the bar and meet all his friends. Then we go to another bar. And I had no self-respect back then, by the way. So I'm like, I'm going to hang out with this guy. So we go to another bar. It's like 8 in the morning, maybe. And everyone is wasted, and he starts texting some girl, and he's kind of ignoring me now, of course. And he's texting, this girl comes in, this beautiful girl comes in. She goes immediately over to him, and they start dancing. I was like, oh, okay, I get it. I'm being replaced. Okay, he's like going to fuck 2 girls in 1 night. That's pretty impressive, actually. I've done it now, but anyway. Tinder's the best thing that ever happened to me. Anyway, this is pre-Tinder. God, I didn't need to go into all these details. Anyway, so they're all like, you know, hanging out, and I'm like, okay, I gotta get out of here. This is embarrassing. So I had left my sweater in the car because I didn't realize that I was getting ditched. So I was like, I'm gonna get my sweater. And so we all go out to the car. Me and Sebastian and the girl that's replacing me and all of his friends are walking to the car together. I'm like, this is awesome. And the girl comes up to me and she starts talking to me and she's like, "Hey, are you American?" And I was like, "Yeah." She's like, "I'm Jessica." Jessica. "I'm from Canada." And I was like, "Oh, hey." And we start talking. And this girl's awesome. Like, I like this girl. Like, I love her energy. I hadn't spoken English in a long time to someone. You know, we got the North American connection. And then we start doing like, blah, 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 blah. We're just like talking, talking, talking. And the guys are like, "What the fuck?" So finally we get back to the car. Sebastian gets in the car with his friends. We're just keep talking. And then he's like, "Meep, meep." You know, like, "All right, fuck this bitch." Anyway. And she's like, I gotta go. Before I do, though, she's like, did I, you know, get in the way of something here? You know, were you gonna hook up with him? I was like, oh, no, I already fucked him. You can have him. I was like, I hope you don't, you know, mind. Like, I mean, I actually, like, I think you and I should be friends. Is that cool or is that weird? She's like, no, you're awesome. I want to be your friend. I don't care about that guy. I'm just gonna fuck him. And I'm like, yeah, you and I are totally gonna be friends. Yeah. So we give each other numbers. She offers to pay for my cab ride home. I'm like, no, I gotta walk out my shame. We go off and fuck, and I go back to get back to the other counselor's place, and I check my email, and of course there's an email from Tuna. He's like, oh, totally, let's hang out. And I was like, God damn it, Melanie, this is totally why you're single. You're like, as soon as a guy, you know, doesn't pay attention for a second, you're like, fuck all men. Anyway, so Tuna and I ended up hanging out for a while after that. We kind of started dating, and I kind of started to fall for him a little bit. And then Jessica and I became like best friends. The next week we went on a climbing expedition in Patagonia together. Like, I don't realize that's like a crazy thing to say right now. Expect to laugh enough. Anyway, so we become good buddies, which takes the pressure off Tudo, because you never have all your friends and the guy you're fucking is one person. Anyway, so one day, Tudo and I go out to the bar, he's pretty drunk, and we run into Jessica, and I hadn't seen her in a few days, and she was like, oh my God, Melanie! And she's like, oh my God, how you been doing? She gives this huge hug, and then she's like, hey, Tudo! And she goes, isn't she just a pearl? Like, isn't Melanie just this pearl you met at, like, the bottom of the ocean, just this special, like, jewel or whatever? And because dude's drunk, and drunk people don't know how to act, he was like, yeah, sure. And I'm like, after that, I started to notice, like, more because of that insightful moment. I realized that I go to his band practice all the time. I go and hang out with all his friends, like, you know, things just seem a little bit different from that moment, because I'm like, I don't know, it's very insightful. So one day I get a call from Kevin Allison, who runs this awesome podcast called Risk, and he asked me if I wanted to do a story from down there. So I recorded it, and then I told Tudo about it, and he was like, that's cool. And then I told Jessica about it, she was like, oh my God, that's awesome, what is a podcast? And I'm like, and I was like, that's when I realized, I was like, well, motherfucker, like, the guy I'm, like, dating doesn't know me at all. Like, believe me, I am willing to talk about myself a lot. They gotta ask questions, right? So I'm, like, more of his fan than a partner. He doesn't even know I'm a comedian, and that's, like, the most important thing in my life. I'm like, this motherfucker don't think I'm a pearl. And I'm pretty sure, now I can be wrong because I'm still new at like dating and healthy relationship mentality, but I'm pretty sure that the guy that you're sleeping with, that you're dating, that you're fucking, is supposed to think you're as cool, if not cooler, than like your best friend, right? Because you get to fuck me and be my best friend. Like, that's a double win, right? That's a healthy relationship, right? Best friend and fuck? Anyway, okay, good. All right. So Jessica and I ended up traveling all over the place together. She came on my family vacation with me to Barbados. And while we were hanging out, my parents were like, yeah, you guys are just like sisters. You're so close. And they're like, how'd you two meet? And I'm like, we caught the same guy in the same night, would you believe it? No. It's like, oh, mutual friend. Sebastian had actually friended her on Facebook and not me. So he's seeing all these pictures of her and I together all over Argentina, and you know, like now we're in Aruba together, I think. And he messaged me and goes, did you know that girl before we go? Jesus. No, but thank you so much for introducing us. So the reason why I wanted to tell the story is because, you know, you're not supposed to fuck people who don't think you're a pearl. And you guys, I bet if I was attracted to Jessica, I would marry that bitch, man. I'm so glad that Brett, you found that Sebastian thinks you're a pearl, and that Brett thinks you're a pearl, Sebastian. I love you guys both. Thank you. Thank you so much, Molly. When we were in our first improv team together, she would refuse to do, she didn't want to do monologue openings for our improv sets because she didn't have any good stories. Literally refused. We're like, and then we would end rehearsal. She'd be like, one time my mom let a nest of wasps live in our living room for a summer. And we're like, that's a really good story. You should listen to a story. Yeah. Okay, cool. So everyone's returning back. This is great. So I'm going to introduce the next person. Okay, here we go. Sarah Yoder!
Hi, everyone. So I think this kicks off the official serious part of this human gay ass wedding. But I have two readings to share with you today. It is, no, there is no religion in this whatsoever. it's only a few years ago that this wedding would not have been able to happen. So I am sharing two readings of the things that made it possible. Civil marriage is at once a deeply personal commitment to another human being and a highly public celebration of the ideals of mutuality, companionship, intimacy, fidelity, and family. It is an association that promotes a way of life, not causes, a harmony in living, not political faiths, a bilateral loyalty, not commercial or social projects. Because it fulfills yearnings for security, safe haven, and connection that express our common humanity, civil marriage is an esteemed institution and the decision whether and whom to marry among life's momentous acts of self-definition. That is from the first case allowing gay marriage in Massachusetts, Goodrich versus Department of Public Health in 2003. No union is more profound than marriage, for it embodies the highest ideals of love, fidelity, devotion, sacrifice, and family. In forming a marital union, two people become something greater than they once were. Marriage embodies a love that may endure even past death. It would misunderstand these men and women to say they disrespect the idea of marriage. Their plea is that they do respect it so deeply that they seek to find its fulfillment for themselves. Their hope is not to be condemned to live in loneliness, excluded from one of civilization's oldest institutions. They ask for equal dignity in the eyes of the law. The Constitution grants them that right. And that was from Obergefell v. Hodges in 2015 from the Supreme Court. Thank you so much, Sarah. So very quickly, because then we're gonna move to the kind of more presentational, fancy parts of the wedding. I wanna very quickly just talk about two of my best friends, Brett and Sebastian. Okay, sorry. I didn't say that, I said a forest. I met Brett in October 2006. We took our first improv class with our Yukitas. We were like friendly, I think, in that first class, and it wasn't until we took 201 and I like just randomly signed up for another one and I showed up and our other friend Jess was also in the class, and like basically like a third of our improv 101 took the same class. Again, we were just like happened to be in the same one, and yeah, from then on we were like we were good friends, and that's been, I think, maybe one of the defining relationships of my adult life has been my friendship with you. And I'm very appreciative of it. And when you first started dating Sebastian, I remember the first time I met Sebastian, and he was just this like, just smiling and so sweet and like funny. And, cause I think when you're a comedian, sometimes comedians date normals. And it can be fine. Sometimes it's okay. And then sometimes it's like, that is not what happened with Sebastian. And I think it was either the first or second time I met you, I think I turned to you and I was like, hey, so if you guys break up, we still gotta be friends though. Like, cause this is great. And you're like, yeah, okay. I think for both of you, you're just like two of the most special people in my life. I love you both so much. I rely on you a great deal as friends. So thank you so much for letting me be a part of this. I love you both so, so much. So please, we're going to have a very special treat. So please welcome to stage Amy Schwartz. Amy Schwartz. I think she's all the way to the back.
I'm just, Sebastian and I don't know any of you. hello, and you must be Brett. Okay, wonderful. I have known Sebastian for 14 years. We went to Wash U together. I know. I was in the Wash U contingent back in the corner. And we lived together for 2 years. And when we were living together, I feel like it's safe to say that you had a rather unsuccessful dating experience in college. Yeah.
Chris Jensen.
Sebastian is one of my best friends, and Chris Jensen is also one of my best friends. So, hi, that was a lot of fun. But anyway, that didn't work. And I just remember sitting with Sebastian on his bed, eating cookies and marathoning Law & Order SVU, as we were wont to do. And he, at the time, he said something to the effect of just, he wanted to hold out for his special person. And I personally thought that was a very interesting concept and something I wasn't trying, so maybe I should think about that. Hello, college. That was many years ago, and then Sebastian moved to New York and I moved to London, and our lives, obviously, thank God for iMessage, that's all I'm gonna say. It was really sad for me. Happy but sad when Brett came into Sebastian's life, because there was this person who was so important to my best friend, and I didn't know him, and I was really jealous, and I was also very concerned that this person did not deserve my Sebastian. Very concerned. But then I met him, and I think that I can speak for everybody here who loves you, because they're here.
I'm good with people who aren't.
Yeah, well.
We'll talk about that after.
Later, that's for later. But I think I speak for everybody here who loves Sebastian as much as I love Sebastian, that Brett, we wouldn't part with him to a lesser man. And I am so happy that Brett, that you held out for Sebastian, and Sebastian, that you held out for Brett. So I'm just gonna sing a song and see how this goes. So you can.
Thank you.
larger than mine. Sometimes after midnight, in my wildest fantasies, some would just be on my reach, there's someone reaching back to me. Racing on the thunder and rising with the heat. It's gonna take a Superman to sweep me off my feet. I need a hero! Oh, never a hero till the end of the night. He's gotta be strong, and he's gotta be fast, and he's gotta be fresh from the fight. I need a hero! I'm holding up for a hero till the morning light. He's gotta be strong and he's gotta be soon. And he's gotta be larger than light. I need a hero.
Homes in this world. I think that people look for love all their life. And I think that people are searching for home. Whenever they leave, whenever they go out in the world, they try to find a place that reminds them of where they came from, of the things that make them feel that they are who they are. Someone that makes them feel special. Someone that makes them feel that they can do anything and they can be anyone. Someone that makes them feel loved. Because they know that the person that's looking back at them loves them just as much as they love that person. And it's not just Brett and Sebastian. I want everyone to take a second to look around this room. Look around. We're from everywhere. All of us came from all around the world. And why? Because these two men know how to make you feel like you're at home. They open their hearts up to each other. They open their hearts up to us. And that's why we're here. Because we're honored that you have looked at all of us the same way that you've looked at each other and accepted us as your friends and family the way that you've accepted each other. Step in and hold hands. Sebastian, I want you to repeat after me. I, Sebastian.
I, Sebastian.
Take you, Brett.
Take you, Rachel.
Lawfully wedded husband.
To be my lawfully wedded husband.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
For richer or poorer.
For richer or for poorer.
But I know it will be richer.
Yeah, I know it will be richer.
Because when I'm with you.
Because when I'm with you.
I know that there's nothing that we can't accomplish together. Until they run out of Pokemon. Until Pagliacci stops crying. Until the stars fall out of the sky.
Until the stars fall out of the sky.
Brett.
Hi.
Repeat after me. Hi, Brett.
Hi, Brett.
Take you, Sebastian.
Take you, Sebastian.
To be my lawfully wedded husband.
Ooh. To be my lawfully wedded husband.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness, all my sinus infections. And in health, which.
For richer or poorer.
For richer or poorer.
But I know it will be richer.
I know it's gonna be rich.
Because I have you in my life.
You in my life.
Until the phalanx invade.
Phalanx invade, which if the backup X-Men aren't ready, I don't.
Until they stop making cravats.
Until they stop making cravats.
Until there's not a sitcom in the world that I can't comment on.
You have to repeat things. Until there's a sitcom that I can't comment on.
Until the stars fall out of the sky.
Until the stars fall out of the sky.
Guys, I think everybody in this room is so appreciative of everything that you've done, not just for us, but for each other. To make a life, to build a world, and to be yourselves. The The world's hard. Life's hard. You know, we all get stressed, we get scared. But every time that happens, just remember, when you're out there, that every night, you get to come home to your best friend. And now, ladies and gentlemen, it is my honor to introduce to you the greatest superhero team that has ever been assembled. Sebastian Deken and Brett White, Mr. and Mrs. Wait, check my notes. Mr. and Mr. Sebastian Deken and Brett White!
We're gonna leave now first, and then that's
when you guys get to start.
Okay, great.
Yeah.